First of all, thank you and welcome to new subscribers. And yes, if you subscribed because you were interested in a free reading, I just wanted to say, just a quick catch up before I do the reading, just a couple of quick announcements. First of all, I am going to be doing some more free readings, but they will be a competition. I'm going to do 2 free readings at the end of July, and I might make that a regular thing. But I just thought it would be nice to do some readings that would allow me to reach more people, to help more people. So I've split these up in signs. So I'm doing readings for all signs and for the month of July. But what I'll do is I will look to see which of the videos has been the most popular. In other words, which ones received the most comments and likes and things like that. And then from that video, if everyone just makes sure that they comment under the video, when they comment they do mention whether or not they'd like to have a free reading. If you want to comment just for commenting, that's great, that's fine as well. But what I'll do is I will choose from the most popular video, I'll take all the names of people who've said they'd like a reading and I'll put them in a hat at the end of July, and then I will do 3 free readings which will be posted on the channel. So if you've looked at the free readings playlist and you've seen those, you'll see what I mean, you'll know what I'm talking about, and you could have one of those. Those are on display because they're completely free, and that was kind of the agreement. But if you do book a private reading, all the details are under the video in the description box. That is completely private. You get a completely private link sent to you, or it might be audio, or it might be on Skype. But either way, if you do book a reading with me, it is completely private. But if I do one of these giveaway things and you win a free reading, that will be posted on the channel. That's it. Thank you so much again for coming to watch the video, and I hope you have a fantastic July, and I'll speak to you soon. Hello lovely Capricorn, this is your reading, your Angelscope, Tarotscope and Astrological Overview for the month of July 2017. So, for you Cappies, it's going to be the 7th house that gets the focus for most of July. Sun in Cancer, so you're going to be thinking very much about your relationships, of all kinds, partnerships of all kinds, whether they are work partnerships or intimate romantic relationships and connections. You're even going to be thinking about your own connection with yourself. So, and what you need, what it takes for you to feel emotionally secure, whether those things, which of those things is actually giving you a sense of emotional safety and security. You might also be looking back over family experiences and the past, and just re-evaluating your relationships completely in the light of everything that you've experienced. And it's both basically going to be your focus for July, relationships. Okay, so let's just have a quick look at what the cards say. Not focusing entirely on relationships, but looking at that area in the context of the rest of your life in the month of July. What do Capricorns need to know? Holy Spirit, precious guides and angels, please guide me, give me the right words. Universe, give me the right cards. Okay, throat chakra. So, there is someone you need to speak to. There's something you need to say, Capricorn, this month in July, and there's someone you need to say it to. You need to be able to express yourself truthfully and freely, and you need to be able to trust your words. You need to trust your truth, trust that you know the truth, know what's going on, and allow yourself to speak it. Allow yourself to say the words that you don't want to say, allow, you know, things that you might not want to admit to yourself even. Allow yourself to speak your truth about what is currently happening, and allow yourself to open up a dialogue with anyone else who may be concerned. And if you're unattached at this time, it may simply be that your key to finding your way in relationships in the future is through being fully expressed yourself, expressing your own divine truth, your own purpose, your own words, whether this is through speaking, singing, writing, journaling. You need the stuff in you that needs to come out if you're going to find the right connection or heal a connection that you might be in at the moment. It's very powerful to have that card there, and it really, really seems as if it wants to stay there and it's not going anywhere. It's like it's time, Capricorn, for you to speak your truth and to be fully connected who you are and fully realized, I'm hearing. Okay, so I think that will apply to lots of different areas. We've got fertility here, so you are full of ideas. You're full of ideas, you're full of creativity, you're full of plans. You know, even if you wouldn't call it creativity, you've got business ideas or schemes or things that you want to put into action, or, you know, ideas for a move or things that you want to make or people you want to contact and connect with, you know, and partner with maybe. Maybe the partnership thing for you is about, I might like to do a business with this person, or I think maybe I want to connect with that person and have a really good conversation about some of the things that I've got swimming around in my mind at the moment. Very fertile time, very, very, very creative time for ideas for you. Okay, and so which, you know, it's like seeing this, it's almost like seeing someone who's a songwriter or something, because we've got the throat chakra and then we've got this fertility and creativity. You know, this kind of feminine principle of just being very, very fertile and very full and able to bring things through, channel things through. If you were a channel as well, if you were feeling very, very inspired recently and felt that you wanted to give talks or speak and inspire people, particularly young people, you know, this is the sort of combination that I'd expect to speak. So really exciting. I almost feel a bit emotional. I feel like some Capricorns have waited their whole lives to get to this point where they feel they're ready to express whatever this is, a new vision, a new dream, a new idea, a new thing, a new way of giving back to the world, or doing something that really makes your mark. You know, this is why you've got this card of being fully expressed and really being who you are. Okay, and for some that will be being a mother, becoming a mother, or, you know, becoming, you know, conceiving, or becoming, waking up to your role as a mother to the world. So, you know, that desire to work with young people and to open your heart to them and pour out. People misunderand Capricorns. They can be very, very loving, and you know, their practicality and their plodding nature, their ability to see things through and get control over their material circumstances, they often turn around and put that to really good use in the wider world, making them really great philanthropists. So, you know, this is the general energy, okay, that's around for you in July. And you will be coming into balance with all of this, with all of these ideas, with all of this fertility. And I feel that when I look at this 11, it makes me think of the gateway, the 11-11. It makes me think of you rising in consciousness to the point where you will say, right, that's it. This stuff has been in the realm of ideas and dreams and schemes for long enough now. I want to start putting some of it into practice. For some of you, it will simply mean a change of job. For some of you, it will mean a change of home, a change of residence, a change of hobbies and interests. But it's something where you're full of it and it needs to happen now. Okay. The shadow. Okay. So you're looking at yourself from all sides. You're looking at what needs to be healed within you. You're looking at what stopped you in the past. You're looking at old childhood wounds and issues and beliefs that you may have had that have prevented you from having the right kind of relationship, or a relationship that really, really nurtures you and nourishes you and allows you to feel that emotional sense of stability. So there are things that you're clearing. You're going quite deep. You've been looking quite deeply at yourself and your role in relationships. And what I allow myself to accept is what I'm hearing. There's almost a feeling of, why have I allowed myself to accept so little sometimes? For some Capricorns, not all of you, okay? So, moving out of a period of solitude that gave you a good opportunity to reflect. And the book again, you know, I'm thinking about journaling, I'm thinking about writing things down on paper to do with myself, to do with my past. I feel this may have been a theme for some of you, where you've put it down on paper so that you can see it clearly, so you can understand it, so you can understand yourself. It could be that you've been writing down new ideas to do with a new venture, to do with leading people forward in some way. You can be a very good, strong leader, but the planning and the dreaming and the scheming, it's as if you've needed the time in order to do that, and that's the period that you're moving out of. So you're moving into now the period where it feels like, again, there's more that you have to put into place before you can move ahead fully. So it could just be that you've applied for something, or you've suggested or recommended something to someone and you're waiting for an answer to come back. Or it could be that you know that you've got all the ideas, you've got all the plans, you're ready to birth them, but you're still not quite free of your constraints, you know, practicalities that will give you the time to actually put it into practice. Okay, so July, let's see, where are we? Our attitude is the temptation to get to fall back into something that's not good for us is so strong sometimes, and you're being encouraged not to look that way, but to look to the future, to look to future plans, to look to brighter days, to look to being self-realized without interruption, without fear, without being dragged backwards, okay? To be able to move forward freely, to be fertile, to bring your gifts to the earth, to nurture, to not get stuck on things that dangle a carrot in front of you that promise so much but give so little. Okay, that's how I'm hearing it in the context of this reading. Can mean many things. Okay. Environment, solar plexus chakra, which is all about empowerment. It's all about, again, coming into your personal power, but more than ever, this one. And this with this, you know, very strongly suggests to me that it's possible that you've been manipulated in the past into a period of feeling disempowered, into a situation that disempowers you time and time again, because this is all about your personal power. You know, the name for the solar plexus chakra in Sanskrit, I think, is Manipura, which always sounds to me like manipulation. If someone wants to manipulate you, they always send the cords towards the solar plexus chakra to try to pull you. You know, so if you're in anything like that, that feels like, why do I keep going back to this person, or why do I keep falling back into this job, or why do I keep falling back into this habit of thinking, you might want to do some energy clearing and really, really energize your solar plexus chakra and bring the light and the wisdom in there of pure self-empowerment and self-realization. A lot about self-realization for you, Capricorn, and that's what's going to give you the strength to make the changes and to manifest the dreams that you have, okay, in July. And then you will be able to have a relationship that supports your dreams and goals and that doesn't unseat you and pull you off balance all the time, okay? So, and if you've left a situation like that behind recently, well done, congratulations, keep walking. And you have a sense of triumph, but this is in your hopes and fears position. So you're kind of afraid that it might be short-lived, or that you might be jumping the gun, or you might be deluding yourself. Trust yourself, don't be afraid to succeed, okay? You can have that triumph, you can have those goals succeeding, and you can successfully walk away from toxic situations. It's a good time for you to do that. So very, very powerful July for you, and your outcome, wow, accelerated motion. That is a great place to have that card right at the end there. So basically what it's saying is that if you follow the path that you're on and keep trusting yourself and walking away from temptation and getting strong within your core, you might even want to do some physical exercises. So if you've fallen out of a workout routine or anything like that, like, you know, the stronger you get in your physical core, the more able you're going to feel to kind of, you know, have that powerful energy where you want it and keep moving forward in strength and confidence, okay? Really important. So get back into your, I don't know, core strengthening activities, whatever you do, whether it's Pilates or yoga or actually being down in the gym with a trainer, whatever, you know, strengthen your core, work on your solar plexus chakra, and you will see accelerated motion in July. And that can be motion in your plans, or it can be motion in your putting them into, you know, moving the wheels forward, because you get that burst of confidence, okay? Do it, do it, do it. You are the one that's going to make it happen. You are the one you've been waiting for. And there is a wonderful connection waiting for you at the end of this rainbow, okay? Just trust yourself. Trust yourself. And if you are already in a connection, if you are coupled, Capricorn, but you keep falling back into negative situations work-wise, just ask for the support that you need in relationships, because relationships, you know, if that's very much your theme for July, you need to look at how they either support or hinder you, if that makes sense. So it could be either. Okay, let's do past, present and future for Capricorn for July. Past, time to move on. So you've moved on from something. So, you know, this is what the temptation thing is. You have moved on. It's in the past. You know, walking away, and then there's always a temptation to keep looking back. Can you see? She's walking. She's like in the ocean. She's flowing. She's in a flow. She's got her own vibe, her own groove on. And every now and again, she just seems to just keep looking back to see, oh, what if, what if, what if, what if, what if? Okay. So, well done for moving on. Okay. Where you are now. Father healing. Okay, so for a lot of Capricorns, and this definitely is to do with, I feel, the ones that are healing wounds in relationship issues. There is an issue with a father figure or a father energy or a father in your life. Either a fracture or a damaged relationship or an absence or something like that, but where that person wasn't there for you, or where that person there was a toxic influence around that energy. It may not be your father, it could be a grandfather or a father figure or a father energy, or it could be your father. It doesn't mean they were abusive. It could be a sense of loss, a sense of longing. It could have been a bereavement. There's something where that father energy in a healthy sense is missing, and this is what you're healing at the moment. So it's the most powerful thing that's happening for you in relationships at the moment, and when you do that healing, that's when the magic is going to start to happen in partnerships for you, okay? It says your personal power increases as you give any father-related issues to heaven. That's where you are now. And moving into the future, wow, music for manifesting. Really powerful, Capricorn. You're not necessarily known as being, you know, a creative or a musical sign, but you are highly, highly, highly creative, and obviously you have many, many, many planets in your sign that will be in other positions, so we can't make any assumptions about any of the signs. You know, people talk about Virgos being really nitpicky and practical and all this stuff, but what do you say about a Virgo with a moon in Pisces and Neptune in Scorpio? You know, we can't sort of have these stereotypes. But so what I'm saying is, music is going to be very important for you in July, and it's going to be a way for you to release yourself completely from the shackles of stereotypes that you have in your own head about who you are and what you can achieve. It's going to be a way for you to become more playful again, and that playfulness will allow you to bring in the manifestations of what you want. So it can be that you start singing, it can be that you just listen to music more, it can be that you get dancing, and all of that frees you up to see yourself differently, to think differently about life, and to let things flow in a more easy and divine way. Then, you know, I also feel that, you know, for some Capricorns, there is more of a fun relationship or connection coming in a bit later down the line. You may have been in something that was a bit serious, okay? And it may be that you're going to be manifesting a new partner through connecting with music and fun and joy and lightness. Someone who is of that vibration, who enjoys those things much more, rather than being bogged down in seriousness. Okay, that's it, Capricorn, for now. Hope you have a fantastic July. I'll see you again in August. If you'd like to book a reading with me, a personal reading to look a bit deeper, the links are below the video. And if you want to enter my prize draw for a free reading, just comment and like and share and let me know. All right, take care. Have a great August, a great July, and I'll see you in August. Bye.